Hello, Year 2 students. My name is Ella and I'll be your teacher today. And believe it or not, we are up to lesson 12. So let's get going. What will we need? Well, today we're going to need a pack of cards and our hundreds, tens and ones. Remember we made them last lesson? Our hundreds, tens and ones. Okay, let's have a think about last lesson. Our lesson was called 10 of these is one of those. And we learnt through our base 10 game, and I hope you had fun doing that, that 10 of these is one of those. 10 tens is 100. Okay, now let's start with a warm-up number talk. It's about place value. So let's have a look at today's place value. Here's our hundreds and our tens and our ones. My first question is, what is this number? Let's have a think. Okay, I think we should start at our hundreds. And let's see, I can see this by subitizing. I can see that I've got a 3 and a 2 or a whole group of 5. So I'm going to write underneath, I have 5 hundreds. How many tens do I have? Once again, by subitizing, I can see a row of 5 and I can see 2. I know that 5 and 2 makes 7. I have 7 tens. And for my ones, nice and easy, 2 and 2 or a group of 4, I have 4 ones. So my number today is 574. Well done. I think there's two other ways to write this number. So let's have a think. I could write it, I have 500. I have, 7 tens, like 70, and I have 4 ones. So another way to write 574 is 500 plus 70 plus 4, or 570 and 4. Another way I could write this is by using the words I have in front of me. So I can write 500. I can have 7 tens and I have 4 ones. These are two ways of representing this number. You might think of something else as well. Okay, my last question for you is, what if I change some things around? So, what if I took away 1, 1? What will my number be? Let's have a think. 574 take away 1. We also might write this as, what is 1 less than 574? 1 less than 574 is, I can see it there, I've taken 1 away, 573. And my last question for you today in our number talk is, what if I took away 2 tens? What if I took away 2 tens or 20? What if I took that away? What would my number now look like? Let's have a think. 574 take away 2 tens. 2 tens is 554. 554. Well done. OK, Okay, today's learning intention is we're going to represent and make some three-digit numbers. We're going to use our randomizer today to help us pick some numbers to make, draw, and write. And we'll know we can do this when we can model our three-digit numbers and understand the parts of each three-digit number. So, to start with, we'll need a place value mat. We drew one last lesson, but let's have a look at how we did that because we may need to draw some more. So I started with a rectangle. And I needed one line for our headings. I don't need a line right in the middle, but I need one to the side and to the side. And that will give me three parts. These are our hundreds, these are our tens, and these are our ones. I hope you remember drawing that from last time. Okay, so what I need in my ones is my beautiful 10 frame. My 10 frame is a rectangle divided in the middle. Think about the middle and go just below it to make my first 2, 3, and 4. Let's check because sometimes we make too little or too much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 5. 5 and 5 make 10. That's my 10 frame. Okay, we're ready to randomize a number, a three-digit number which will have hundreds, tens, and ones in it. Let's have a look. Here's our first number. We have our hundreds, tens, and ones. And randomly, we have found a number 200, 110, and 5 ones. How do we say this number? I think I can hear that. 215. Okay, let's make our number 215, and we'll start with our hundreds. 2 hundreds. 2 hundreds. How many tens? 1. 1 10. How many ones? 5 ones. So I have been able to make my number 215. 200s, 110, and 5 ones. I've made it, now I need to draw it. So I've had a go at that myself. Here is my making place value mat, and here is my drawing of my place value mat. 200s, 110, 5 ones makes 215. Partitioned is 200 plus 10 plus 5. So there's my recording. Remember, we've randomized it, we've made it, we've drawn it, and we've written it. Okay, well done. Now let's make another three-digit number with our most magnificent randomizer. I'm going to flick backwards and forwards and ins and outs and make a few different numbers. And we'll go backwards. What have we got? 5, 2, and 3. How do we say this three-digit number? We say 523. All right, let's make it. How many ones? How many hundreds? Here we go. 5 hundreds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hundreds. how many tens? Two. Two tens. And how many ones? Three. Three ones. Okay. We've made our number. That's right. Now we're going to draw it. I'll draw this one with you. So, here we have a smaller place value chart I can draw in my book. Hundreds, tens, ones. And to draw what I have made, I'm going to draw one, two, three, four, five, five hundreds, five hundreds, two tens, two tens, and three ones. I'm still going to use my tens chart. And this will help me remember that 10 of these is one of those. How many do I have in here? I have three. Make it, draw it, now let's write it. We have 523. 523. Bit squishy. And I also want to write it as a partition. So I'm going to write 500 plus 20 plus 3. I think your challenge will be to make it a little bit less squishy than mine. Okay, well done. Let's try one more on the magnificent randomizer. So I think I will try and pick some different numbers. Let's try this one. So we have 3 in the hundreds, 6 in the tens, and 8 in the ones. And this number is 368. Let's make it. 3 hundredths. Six tens. And eight ones. I think that's going to almost fill up my ten chart. There we go. What a beautiful number. 368. Remember, we're going to make it. You'll need to draw it and then write it. Off you go. Let's reflect now. We've learnt lots about three-digit numbers. We've learnt how to make it, draw it, and write it. Let's have a look at an example. This is what Laura drew. So, she must have made it, drawn it. Let's see what we can write. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I can recognize that as subtitled 4, 2 and 2. So I'm going to write 4 as my 100. 2, 2 and 1. So I can see that that is a 5 tens. And let's have a look at our ones. So I have 5 and 2. My ones is 7. Laura drew the number 457. If I partition the number 457, I'll come up with 450 and a 7. Well done, Laura. That's a beaut number. Now, what's your task today? You might remember I mentioned a pack of cards. So what I'd like you to do is find your cards, but pull out these numbers. We won't need them today. We won't need our jokers. We won't need our picture cards, and we won't use our tens. So now I've got those pulled out from the pack. I'm going to use the rest of my pack to make some three-digit numbers. Let's try. I wonder if you're any good at shuffling. Sometimes I shuffle this way. Sometimes I put them out and mess them up. Let's play the game. So I'm going to deal three cards, a five, a nine, and an ace. Let's use ace as a one. Okay, what have I got? I've got five hundreds, I've got nine tens, and I've got one ones. So this number is 591. I'm going to make it, I'm going to draw it, and I'm going to write it. Your task is to finish the pack of cards or fill up a page of our place value game and our three-digit numbers. It's great practicing. I hope you enjoy it. Go ahead, you powerful mathematicians, and I will see you next time.